Good morning. Welcome, friends, to Colonial Park United Church of Christ, where no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. We welcome you on this beautiful rainy Sunday, and are glad that you were able to join us, whether it be here in our sanctuary or online. Thank you for joining us in worship. Please let your attendance be made known through our attendance pad here in the service or online through our online attendance pad. Happy Labor Day weekend to everyone. I guess you wish people a happy Labor Day, but really it's more a matter of thank you for coming out on a holiday weekend. A number of announcements, most of which are in your bulletin, but I want to highlight a few things. First of all, this week, some upcoming activities. On Tuesday night, since the first Monday of this month is a holiday, on Tuesday night will be Women's Spirituality, and all women of the church are invited as friends as well. We will be offering that, hopefully, online as well as in person in our church parlor. So please come out. We usually start at 6:30 with a time of connection, and then a time of prayer at 7, and then a time of discussion at 7:45. Wednesday night, then, there is a meeting for parents of youth and for youth. That will be on Zoom at 7:30. If you need the link for that, please see me. Next Sunday is extremely full. It is Rally Day, which is an invitation for you to bring a friend, to bring family, to come back to church, to connect. And we will have a time of celebration in the service and sort of kick off our Sunday school year and bless our teachers. We will also be dedicating and blessing our new angel that's in our memorial garden, as well as our labyrinth. And then following that, we'll be feasting together. There are details in there. I believe we are providing the main dish, and you all are invited to bring some sort of a side dish or dessert. Oh, and before I forget, there will be ice cream and milkshakes. So if that's a plus for you, make sure you come. Also, next Sunday in the afternoon, we have received two invitations. One is from Salem UCC downtown, and the pastor there, Sue, said, I wanted to let you know and invite you that next Sunday we are going to have the Shalom House food truck at Salem during our gallery walk next Sunday from 12 to 5. So in the afternoon, if you, especially if it's a nice day, they encourage you to see the work that Shalom House is doing, the ministry that they have with women in the community. But also enjoy some time together. Also, next week in the afternoon at 3 o'clock is the installation of our conference minister, Reverend Dr. Carrie Call, and that will be at 3 o'clock online. So it's a live streaming event. If you wish to participate in that, you should be able to find details in your bulletin. Also, as many of you know, we have been doing a good bit of work as our capital campaign has begun and is going well. One of the things that we've been doing is working with the brick on this outside wall at our memorial garden. And as many of you know from projects at home, sometimes you find things that you weren't planning on. And we found a little bit of something here that we weren't necessarily planning on that requires us to move and repair one of the classroom walls upstairs. And so a special thank you to half-day play teachers who were very accommodating in moving classrooms. But if you are interested in hearing more about what is needing to be done, what is going to be happening, Greg Clark has offered after the service this morning to meet folks upstairs and walk through, answer any questions that you have about that project. So Thank you, Greg, and we just wanted to make you all aware of that. That being said, my shameless plug is, if since it's extra and something we weren't planning on, feel free to donate to the building fund. So just thought I'd throw that out there. Finally, then, before we begin our worship, I'd like to invite Declan Fletterjohn to come forward. Declan is here to share a little bit about his Eagle Scout project. So, Declan.
Good morning. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Declan Fletterjohn, and I've been going to this church for, I think I can say, my whole life. I'm currently working on my Eagle Scout project, which is why I'm talking to you. But this project would entail the creation and installation of AAC communication boards, AAC meaning augmentative and alternative communication. So it assists in communication for nonverbal or minimally verbal children, or children who are just learning to speak, so they can better communicate with their parents, guardians, or caregivers, or just friends. I have a little mock-up of what a board would look like up here. Thank you. If you'd like to help out with the project, we are estimating that this would probably cost around $1,500. So if you would like to help out or donate, you can write out a check to Troop 302 with Declan Fletterjohn Eagle Project in the memo. And you can send all checks to the church office. We'll be collecting them. Thank you.
Thank you, Declan. I was going to say, thank you, Vanna. If you didn't quite follow along all of that, some of Declan's installing these boards to help children who are not necessarily verbal be able to communicate better at playgrounds in the area. One of them being is our Brightville Park right over here. So please take a look at the board, talk to Declan a little bit more, and see about ways that you might be able to be involved to help the children in our community. All of that being said, my friends, let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Thank you. Friends, as we come to our time of our call to worship, just a note that this week being a holiday week, I took the opportunity to put some little bit different pieces in worship this week. So I invite you to sort of pay attention and follow along where need be. But also, you'll notice at least at 2 points within the service, there are responses that are a repeat after me. Part of the reason for that is the folks who scripted some of this liturgy are inviting us to be sensitive to those who are visually impaired. And so by doing a repeat after me, it doesn't require somebody to be able to read or to be able to see what is in the bulletin to give their response. That being said, also one other thing I forgot. It's Communion Sunday. So if you don't have your communion elements, you will want to make sure that you see Cindy Neck in the back if you are here. If you are at home, I won't know that you don't participate in the call to worship. So go get your communion elements now. Our call to worship this morning is in the form of a full body prayer. I'm not going to make you lay on the pew or on the floor, but I am going to ask you to pay attention to your body. So to begin this hour of worship together, we start with a kinesthetic call to worship. This call to worship is a sensory scan of our surroundings to help us open our minds to curiosity, wonder, and awe. I invite you to close your eyes. Take a deep breath in. And release it. First, I invite you to pay attention to touch. What do you feel? Feel your feet on the floor. Feel the earth beneath that supporting you. And thank it for holding you up. Feel the softness of the clothes on your body. thank them for protecting you from the elements. Feel the pew or the chair behind you, behind your back. Thank it for providing you a place to belong. Now I invite you to transition to sound. What do you hear? Listen for the sound of the air. Listen for the sound of your heartbeat. Listen for the sound of the rustles that come with community. And let all these sounds remind you that God is in this space and that we are not alone. Now I invite you to open your eyes. What do you see? Look around this space. Notice who is here. Pay attention to the elements that make this space unique. The windows, the colors, the faces. What's it look like right where you are? Maybe even make eye contact with a neighbor. Breathe in and breathe out. Please repeat after me. This space is holy.
This space is holy.
This space is special.
This place is special.
God is here.
God is here.
We are open to possibility.
We are open to possibility.
Let us pray. Eternal God, to whom all may come through your Son, lay your healing hand upon all those who are sick this day. Make your loving presence known to those who are lonely. Give your strengthening power to those who are weak. May those who lack be filled, those who mourn be comforted, those who worry be calmed, and those who seek forgiveness find it in Jesus Christ. We rejoice as we remember your faithfulness and steadfast love revealed in the risen Christ. Surround us with that faithfulness and steadfast love. Fill us with generosity and courage so that we may be called your friends and go forth to befriend your world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I invite you to rise as you are able in body, mind, and spirit as we join in our opening hymn found in your hymnal on number 70, God is here as we gather, your people meet, verses 1 through 3, number 70 in your hymnal. in place of our traditional elements of confession and assurance today. Our time of reconciliation to God is in the form of a prayer of thanksgiving, our gratitude for love. Let us give thanks for the remarkable gifts of God's creating and redeeming love, the loving that casts out all fear. For love that frees us to ask questions and explore, to frame doubts and investigate new possibilities, to build theories and then cross-examine them.
We thank you, God of adventurous love.
For the love that enables us to marvel at our own existence, to ponder and remember, recognize our own needs, and affirm our own knowledge and purpose.
We thank you, God of determined love.
For the love that helps us to communicate with one another, to express trust and respect, share heartaches and visions, to convey love and mercy.
We thank you, God of reconciling love.
For the love that inspires us to warmly encourage those around us, to affirm and build up, comfort and enlighten.
We thank you, God of nurturing love.
For the love that liberates us to celebrate the world around us in poetry and song, to delight in shapes and colors, intricacies and patterns, awesome forces and deep mysteries.
We thank you, God of visionary love.
For the love that encourages us to express something of our faith, for creeds and prayers, hymns and readings, discussion groups and sermons.
We thank you, God of creative love.
Above all else, we thank you for the love that allows us to admit that we have no words in which to adequately describe the process of faith in Christ, the awesome worship of our God, and the holy wonder of the Spirit. We thank you for that point where our love becomes wordless adoration. Through Jesus Christ, who is the pure glory of your loving. Amen.
Let's sing together.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever. For he is good, he is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful.
Please be seated. Friends, one of the key parts of worship every week, no matter where we are or what the service looks like, is hearing and reading scripture. So today we're going to read our scripture. We're going to read our scripture passage three times. And as we do, we invite you to make note of words and phrases that stand out to you. There's a little space and a gap at the bottom of your bulletin on the page that has our scripture in it. That's for you to doodle in. That's for you to make notes in of what God prompts you with as we read the scripture. Before we read, let us pray. Jesus, you ask questions as much as you answer them. You never shied away from conversation. You were always speaking, sparking curiosity, opening people's minds, and engaging in the art of connection with everyone around you. So we come to your word. Give us the same curiosity, openness, and connection. We are here. We are listening. Amen.
The gospel lesson today comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 15, verses 9 to 17. Listen for the still speaking words of Christ. As you hear God's word, underline the words or phrases that stand out to you. As the Father loved me, I too have loved you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I kept my Father's commandments and remain in his. I have said these things to you so that my joy will be in you and your joy will be complete. This is my commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. No one has greater love than to give up one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I don't call you servants any longer because servants don't know what their master is doing. Instead, I call you friends because everything I heard from my Father I have made known to you. You didn't choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you could go and produce fruit and so that your fruit could last. As a result, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. I give you these commandments so that you can love each other.
This time, as you hear our scripture read aloud again, circle the words or phrases that stand out to you. You might find yourself circling new words or some of the same words from the first reading. As the Father loved me, I too have loved you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy will be in you, and your joy will be complete. This is my commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. No one has greater love than to give up one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I don't call you servants any longer because servants don't know what their master is doing. Instead, I call you friends because everything I heard from my Father I have made known to you. You didn't choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you could go and produce fruit and so that your fruit could last. As a result, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. I give you these commandments so that you can love each other.
Let us listen to our scripture read aloud one last time. This time, in the margins of your paper, in that space at the bottom, write words or phrases, draw images that most captivate you. Hold on to these phrases as a prayer. As the Father loved me, I too have loved you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy will be in you and your joy will be complete. This is my commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. No one has greater love than to give up one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I don't call you servants any longer, because servants don't know what their master's doing. Instead, I call you friends, because everything I heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You didn't choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you could go and produce fruit, and so that your fruit could last. As a result, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. I give you these commandments so that you can love each other. God is still speaking.
Spread the good news.
Some of you will recognize on the bulletin cover some colors and some titles that we've been dealing with for the month of August. And you might say, but Cindy, wasn't that series completed last week? Isn't that what we did last week? Yes. And ideally, had we not been in a pandemic, this service probably would have looked a little bit different. They had in the materials that we received a conversational kind of service where folks were able to turn to one another and have conversation. I figured that probably wouldn't be the best indoors at this time. Nevertheless, we come before our conversational God, and we hear these words of scripture today about Jesus and what Jesus shares about love. Let us pray. Holy God, we thank you for being here, right where we are. In this time and place, as we have heard our Holy Scripture, as our minds have wandered, help us continue to have them wander in the direction that you wish. Help us to continue to explore love. May the words of my mouth, the meditations of our hearts, the Spirit in this place and right where we are be pleasing and acceptable to you, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. So part of the question today is, what conversations communicate love? For there's probably conversations that communicate love that don't even use the word love. Certainly, Jesus' conversation with the disciples, as we heard this morning, had love in it a lot. Perhaps is one of the words that you circled quite a bit. But I think there's probably other conversations, as we've been hearing in recent weeks, that communicate love. Some of the questions that were given in some of the script for today are things like, what place feels most like home, and what do you love about it? What brings you joy these days? What is something that you've learned about yourself in the past year? What's your favorite family tradition? Is there a story behind your name? What's your first memory of grief and of loss? Can you share a story of a time when you felt most like yourself? These are great questions, and there's more, and I wish that I could just give a list and sit down with somebody and talk through these questions, because I think that kind of conversation communicates love and friendship. Jesus does an amazing thing in the scripture text that we have today. He says, I no longer call you servants. I find that interesting because I'm not sure that any of us were thinking the disciples were servants. Especially the word that's used there for servanthood, which is basically can also be translated as slave or enslaved. Obligation to work and to follow. And Jesus says, I no longer call you that. I call you friend. And then Jesus gets to translate what the word friend means, right? No greater love has one than this, than to lay down one's life for a friend. And I call you friends because friends know what friends say and teach and know. And I know that I have told you what God has told me. I've not kept that from you. So we must be friends. Because if I was your master, I wouldn't have told you all of that. It's an interesting conversation. I call you friend. I think one of the things that the pandemic has given many of us is time. Time to not rush quite as much. In fact, I heard somebody comment recently, I don't want to quite go back to the frenetic pace of my pre-pandemic life. I want to be more intentional. I think that's a little bit what this love, this kind of relationship, this kind of connection Jesus is talking about is time, not just certain words that are said, not just a particular kind of conversation, but time. The reality is, and my sermon title shares it, it's a tall order that Jesus gives. Love one another. It may sound easy, but to love one another, to take that time, to have those conversations. And he says it's a command. What is this love and kind of love that Jesus is talking about? By the way, it's the same word that's translated elsewhere as love, but used as husbands love your wives and love your enemies as yourself. It's a pretty significantly deep kind of love. So I was preparing for today, I came across a reading, a writing by Victor Hugo in Les Mis. He writes this, the future belongs to hearts even more than it does to minds. Love, that is the only thing that can occupy and fill eternity. in the infinite, the inexhaustible is requisite. Love participates of the soul itself. It is of the same nature. Love is like the nature of the soul. It is a point of fire that exists within us, which is incorruptible, indivisible, imperishable. It is a point of fire that exists within us that is immortal and infinite, with nothing, which nothing can confine, which nothing can extinguish. We feel it burning even to the very marrow of our bones, and we see it beaming in the very depths of heaven. What a grand thing it is to be loved. What a far grander thing it is to love. The heart becomes heroic by dint of compassion. It is no longer composed of anything but what is pure. It no longer rests on anything that is not elevated and great. An unworthy thought can no more germinate in it than a nettle on a glacier. Again, a pretty deep view of love. I think one of the other titles I could have given, besides it's a tall order, is really, what is friendship? Because many of us can associate love with coupledom. And some have lost loved ones, and so that feels like it's not for them. But that's not who Jesus is talking to here. He's talking to friends with that deep, incredible thing called love. I think the other question that I have is the fact that it's a command. What does it mean that Jesus commands us to love one another, especially if we're not enslaved? Especially if we're not having to obey just because it's the right thing to do or because we're made to. It's not an obligation. So what is this thing that Jesus is inviting us to? It's friendship, and that friendship looks pretty deep. It looks near impossible, actually. That place of friendship that says, I see you, you matter. I love you, I will be with you even in the hurt. It does challenge us to discipleship, but not solely because we're commanded to out of obedience, but commanded to out of friendship. What would I want you to do for me, and how do I do that for you? The golden rule, right? It challenges us to a love that is open, spacious, deep, perhaps time-consuming. In closing, I want to simply read to you one of the last poems by Sarah R. entitled The Way Home. For maybe that's what Jesus was really inviting the disciples to. Do you think when they got to the end of the Edmund Pettus Bridge, they asked, where do we go from here? Do you think when the church voted for all people to preach and lead that they asked, where do we go from here? Do you think when your parents had their first fight with you sleeping peacefully in the next room that they asked in hushed voices, where do we go from here? Do you think that maybe people have been asking this question for as long as we've been asking questions? I don't know for sure, but I do know that I want to ask hard questions with you. So here it goes. Where are you from? Where does it hurt? What do you need? And where do we go from here? I pray, I trust, I believe. If we keep asking, we just might find our way home, as I believe those disciples did so long ago. Amen. we come to our time of prayers of the people, we invite you to share your prayer concerns with us through our blue prayer cards that are in the pew in front of you or online through our prayer request form. You're always welcome to email us or call the church office with your concerns and your celebrations. And we will share those with our prayer chain to be prayed over in the coming weeks. Let us pray. Eternal God, in these moments of quiet, we thank you for your presence in our lives. We thank you for all of the testimonies of your profound love for your children. We especially thank you this day for the Holy One, Jesus. We thank you for his humanity. We thank you that rather than elevating himself above us, he instead would lift us up. And as with his disciples, call us friends. We thank you for his many reminders that we are to love one another, but we confess that we have great difficulty following his command to love. We become upset with others and find it easier to reject them than to seek to understand and to love them. We struggle with the almost impossible command to love our enemies. We become driven to meet our own needs and become blind to the needs of others. We are driven to succeed, which becomes all-consuming and trumps our command to love. Forgive us our foolish ways. Help us to keep in our awareness this command to love, which Jesus repeated so many times. Help us especially to hear it in those hard times when it is most difficult to love. Help us to love others when they are power hungry. Help us to love others when they are inconsiderate. Help us to love others when they are angry and lash out blindly. Help us to love others when they are selfish and insensitive. Help us, O God, to love others so that we may abide in your love and act like the friends of Jesus. Amen.
We bring a portion of all God entrusts to us to be used, not for our pet projects, but for the mission of the church in this community, throughout our land, and around the world. We express our gratitude for the gift of Jesus Christ and for the peace we know deep within when we become disciples and apostles. May we follow the model of God's generosity as we share our tithes and offerings. During the offertory, please bring your prayers and offerings forward and place them in the offering plates. If you are not comfortable doing this, please ask an usher to bring your gift forward. If you are worshiping online, please feel free to share your gifts securely through our website at cpucc.org.
Thankful and broken, given for all, perfect and perfectly torn. Thankful and poured out, covenant divine, receive and be reborn. A new command. my body, this is my blood, bittersweet, purchased and free. Take, eat, and be filled, I am in you. Rise up, for you are in me. A new command I give to you.
Won't you join me in our prayer of dedication? For the hospitality of your good earth, for the people you have given us to love, for the tasks you have called us to do, we give thanks, gracious God. Our offerings are a measure of our faith and an evidence of our gratitude. We dedicate ourselves with our gifts, that your reign of light may be realized in the places where we live and work and far beyond our personal reach. Amen. Please be seated. In many ways, I imagine curious and courageous conversations surrounded being at the table with Jesus. I imagine that between moments of teaching and prophecy, he was turning to his disciples saying things like, what is the hope that you have? What is the story behind your name? What is your favorite food? Tell me more of where you were born, where you hurt, and what you need. It's easy to imagine because Jesus was always seeking deeper connection. Jesus always saw those around him. He saw their joy and their pain. He invited them in and he fed them. He called them friends. He said, I choose you. And that holy love exists for us here too. So friends, come to this time and this table. Come with your questions and your doubts. Come with your joys and your heartache. Come with your hurt and your hope. Come with your heart on your sleeve. Come and know that you are welcome here exactly as you are. There's a seat saved for you. Let us pray. Before I begin the prayer, just a note that in the prayer, there is a time to share what you are grateful for, and I invite you to do so aloud and give voice to it in sort of a popcorn-style fashion. Let us pray. Conversation, God. Scripture tells us that where two or more are gathered, you are there, so we know you are here, right now. We know that you are swirling through our conversations, leaning in to listen to our truths. We know that you hold our hope and our grief, our pain and our love, all in the palm of your hand. And so we speak honestly with you, because we know that you have loved us as no one has ever loved before. Today, God, we are grateful for introductions. We are grateful for awkward elbow bumps and name tags that remind us who we're speaking to. We're grateful for the bravery of storytelling and the deep relief that comes with connection. We're grateful for the creativity and for Scripture, which always reminds us that you are love. We're grateful for familiar faces and new friendships. We are grateful for, and I invite you to share aloud what you are grateful for today.
Shelter.
That said, in the midst of our gratitude, we also carry the heavy reminder that this world is not as it should be. There are people who will leave even this space still feeling lonely. There are people who never made it to this time today because they have been hurt by the church. And there are people who have found connection here but long to find it beyond these walls. Oh God, we are a mess of gratitude and grief, longing to connect with you and one another, so hold us closer today at this table, closer to you and closer to each other. Pour out a double portion of your Spirit on this ordinary bread and cup so that we might be reminded that here at this table, there is a seat saved for us. We are welcome. We are included. We belong here. Let's just let that sink in a minute. We are welcome. We are included. We belong here. We are loved. Now, with the confidence of children, let us pray together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Friends, on the night that Jesus was going to be betrayed, in the midst of fear and confusion, he gathered with his closest friends in a place that had been prepared for them, a meal that had been set out, and they talked. And they laughed, and they ate, and they cried, and they asked questions, and they brought their deepest fears. And they made holy community together. And after all of that had taken place, Jesus took some bread that was left over from the meal, and he lifted it up before them. And he broke it, and he said, "My friends, this is my body, which will be broken for you. Take and eat of it. Do this in remembrance of me." And then he took some wine, and before them he poured it into a cup. And even though they didn't understand at the time, he held it up and he said, "My friends, this is my blood poured out for you for the forgiveness of your sins. So drink of it and be forgiven. Do this for the remembrance of me." My friends, these are the gifts of God for the people of God, you. This is an open table where all Christ's children are welcome, and you are a child of God. So come, bring yourself, bring your fears, bring your tears, bring your joys, bring your concerns, bring your gratitudes, and bring those places where you're just not sure if God fits, because God does. My friends, this is the bread of life. Take, eat, and be made new. Friends, this is the blood of Christ poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Drink and be washed clean.
I invite you to rise as you are able and repeat after me for our prayer after communion. Please repeat after me. God of conversation.
God of conversation.
This space is holy.
This space is holy.
This space is special.
This space is special.
This space is unique because we are fed.
This space is unique because we are fed.
We are seen.
We are seen.
We belong.
We belong.
Help us remain open to possibility.
Help us remain open to possibilities.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us join together in our ascending hymn, "For Everyone Born."
My friends, let us sing together verses 1, 2, and 5.
Forever. everyone born a place at the table, to live without fear and simply to be, to work, to speak out, to witness and worship, for everyone born the right to be free. And God will delight when we are creators of justice and truth,
faith. As you leave this place, may God grant you the curiosity to counter assumptions, the vulnerability to befriend, the bravery to speak your truth, the wisdom to listen, the strength to ask for help, the resiliency to choose love even when it's hard, and the awareness of the Holy Spirit always beside you. In the name of the great connector, love itself, go in peace. My friends, may God bless you. May God keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May God look upon you with favor and say, yes, you are my friend. Amen.